So this tutorial is going to go over sort of cleaning up and prepping your file for 3D printing. So the first thing we do is we import the STL into Meshmixer. I started that process before I started recording because it can be slow. The mesh outputs from Photoshop are quite complex. There are, if you look down here in the lower right hand corner, you can see it's got 1,965,596 triangles. So that's a lot. What we're going to do is sort of simplify the mesh. We're going to orient the mesh into its proper position, and then we're going to check the mesh to make sure that there are no errors in it. Meshmixer, which you can download for free on the internet, is really good at doing this work. So we'll start just by selecting the object. And so you select the select tool, then you double click on the object and give it a second. It can take a second for it to process. And the double click will select the entire mesh. And now we can start to edit the mesh, and so the first thing we want to do is reduce it. So we're just going to go here, edit, reduce, and again the mesh is very complex, so the application may be a little laggy on your computer. And this doesn't really compromise the model at all, unless there were a lot of super fine details. But since we're 3D printing, especially the style that we're 3D printing, which is the extruded thermoplastic, the quality is not super high. Okay, so we'll accept that. You can see there was no real visible change to this. And so now you can see we've gone from 1 million to, I think it was 1.5 million, now we're down to just under 1,982,000 triangles down in the lower right-hand corner. So you can do that a couple times if you want, which may not be a bad idea, just to simplify it. You're just less likely to run into printing problems if the mesh is a bit more simple and less complex in terms of the number of triangles. And each time you do it, it will happen a bit faster because it's having to do fewer calculations. So accept that. Still looks good. Okay, so now we're down to 491. So we've got about a third the number of triangles that we had before. So the next thing we're going to do is go here to analysis. And we want to adjust the orientation. So we basically want to get this ready to print. And right now it's sort of the orientation. It's sitting vertical, which is not the proper orientation to print. You want the largest, flattest surface to sit on the base. And so if we click on Analysis Orientation, it will automatically calculate sort of what the best position for your model to be in for printing. And it will offer that to you as an option. and this is exactly what we want. So we say accept. And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to select Analysis Inspector, Whole Fill Mode, Flat Fill, leave the threshold at that. And basically, it's just looking for any issues that the model may have. And typically, what you do, it's identified three different issues. Just hit Auto Repair All, and it'll repair little issues like either a wrap in the mesh or a fold in the mesh or a hole in the mesh. It'll take care of all those things. And so now we see no issues. So we click Done. And so at this point, the only other thing you may wish to do is the output can be a little noisy, and if that bothers you, you know, you can see there's a bit of a chop on the surface. It doesn't really matter, again, because of the quality of the print. But if you'd like to, you can smooth it out. And so again, we go back to Select, double click. And then under the Select, Deform, Smooth, and you can see it's sort of losing some of the detail, which may be appealing to you, may not be appealing to you. You can adjust the scale of the smoothing up and down with these sliders. And you can see the bigger it gets, the sort of smoother it gets, but also the, I'm trying to just bump it up to like maybe 2. So not super precise. Anyway, I think that's up to you if you want to play around with that. Like this was, I think this default setting was 3 and it was doing quite a lot of smoothing. But it's okay. So I'm not going to do that because I'm not interested. The last thing you're going to do before you save this is go to Analysis, Units, and then you're going to set the final print size. So you can see, even though I exported it as 8 inches from Photoshop, it came into Meshmixer as 8 millimeters. And through some messing about, I realized that it offers you the opportunity to change this to centimeters or inches, but don't. Just basically figure out what your actual size is in millimeters. And so I want to make this about 6 inches square. And so that's about 150 millimeters. And so I'm just going to set the size to 150 millimeters. And then that will resize this to the actual size that I want. And then probably a good idea just to check it to make sure it took. It did. So now I'm going to go to File, Export. And then I'm going to export it as final pattern. There's a lot of different formats. STL binary format is the format that you want. These other formats are for different sort of applications, but STL binary format is what we want for 3D printing. So we'll save that. And so the next step is basically to send it to print.